Hey, today I'm going to be talking to you about Content 360. What is Content 360? Content 360 is a service that will let you post stuff all over the place super easily. It's at content360.io. There's going to be a link below. The link below will be an affiliate link for me. I assume they just send them out to literally everyone because who the heck am I? But assuming anyone uses it, I apparently will get a little bit of money without any expense to you, additional expense. You can also click the link and then get rid of the little stuff at the top so that my affiliate whatever is not there, and then I don't get any money and you pay the same price, so whatever works for you. So if you look at the page, you can see that it's got all the standard trappings nowadays of these sales pages. Scientifically designed to get the psychological tendrils inside of your brain. But you know, you see these landing pages all the time. This one is less smarmy than most of them. There is no like countdown timer, deal ends in 12 minutes and 13 seconds or anything like that. But obviously it's a little hectic. It's a little all over the place. It's got like, you know, these like weird hypotheticals. Imagine this. But let me tell you what it does, because it does do what it says it does, and I've been using it for over a month now, and I'm very happy with it. So assuming it sticks around, which I have no control over, and assuming that it at least maintains its quality currently, I'm incredibly happy with my purchase. It is right now $67 one time, no recurring subscription at all. They say that it's $67 for the first 100 users. I have no idea of knowing how many people have purchased this, but I assume it's more than 100. And then it's going to go up to like 97 a month, and then eventually it'll go into a monthly charge of something like $50 a month. So what does this do specifically? Well, you hook all of your social media accounts up to it that you want to post stuff to. As you can see, I've got 4, 8, 12, 16, almost 20 accounts across all the different like projects that I do. And I'm not like some, you know, I got a full-time job. I do this stuff because I find it fun. I find it entertaining. I find it fulfilling. And the reason I purchased this was because I was going to start some more projects. And this seemed like something that would make that actually feasible, and it has. So I'm just going to go straight down this thing, and I'll talk to you about the ones that I use. The dashboard, I don't use this. I don't care too much. You know, my phone gives me notifications when people do stuff. That's fine. You can click these and get different graphs and stuff. Some of them don't work. The YouTube stuff doesn't work yet. So some of the services, they haven't actually been able to, set up the metrics for currently. But yeah, this will show you in a rolling 7, 30, 90-day period all these different stats for the one that you've got selected. You can also export it right up here at the top. Linkln Bio is interesting. I haven't used it too much because I've already paid for a service that does this type of thing for me. But because this is built in and there's an unlimited amount of Linkln Bio pages you can do, not bad. So I did do a little sample one. It will give me link.content360.io/whatever you choose. And you can put that in your social media profiles. People click it. They get a nice mobile-friendly list of links or other stuff. So if you go to blocks here, you go add block. You can put links, headings, if you want to separate them out, paragraphs for plain text and stuff, avatars, social icons, images, image grid, audio files, PDF documents, videos. You can embed videos, all sorts of stuff. So you can just kind of put whatever you want there, and you can do however many you want. And they got preset themes. You can customize it with your own CSS and color palettes. You just click create link. It says, what do you want to do? File link, a vCard link, event link, a QR code, bio link page is what I did there, shortened URL. You can hook a Content 360 up into Bitly if you have that for your custom short links and things. So very cool. I likely would start using this because it's better, or it's at least equivalent to the service that I already pay yearly for. And this is unlimited. And what I pay yearly for has a max of, I think, 20 pages. So Going down here, we've got the content section with a little plus here. Clicking the plus is the same as clicking this gigantic create post page. Let's go ahead and skip that for now. And we'll just go to posts. And this is going to give me a list of posts that I have done and that I have scheduled. And you can see published, 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 all this. And you got basically like the title of the post or the body of it and a list of any media and the accounts that it went out to. All right, so I can click down here. I scroll down, see a whole bunch of stuff here. This is nice as a really simple overview. If I really want to kind of like look at what I'm doing, I use the calendar view, which we'll get to in just a moment. Bulk posts lets you upload a CSV file, and you can download a template, and then you just fill it in, and it lets you just mass schedule dozens, hundreds of posts, whatever you want. You can only do text posts or image posts. You can't do video yet, is my understanding. And the images have to be hosted somewhere else already. You're not putting these in the file, obviously. So you have to like upload them to like public Google Drive links or Imgur or, you know, a static web host or something. And then you put those URLs in the Excel file, export it as CSV, upload it. It's going to take care of everything. Very cool. A little bit out of the scope of what I would need, but I 100% understand that it's a powerful, powerful tool if you want to do stuff like that. And this right up here, you can see select group. You're going to see this a lot. You can basically group up your social media accounts, and then you click this, and it's going to have those groups right here. If you select them, it's going to pre-populate select the specific ones there. RSS campaigns. I'm gonna keep it real with you guys. I don't know what this does. There's a little video they've got explaining it. I didn't quite get it, and I have not explored it. But you can do RSS campaigns. Calendar. I quite like calendar, so I can scroll down here. This is the stuff that I had scheduled for that week. So. You can see I sit down Friday or Saturday, and then I just schedule everything for the week. It's super, super easy. And then you can also create posts through the calendar as well. So if I go to sometime in the future, that's not the future. You can see there is a plus sign when you hover over these now. So you can go into the create a post dialog with a specific date and time already pre-selected, which is pretty neat. Media library is all the stuff that you've uploaded on to the different posts. It's going to have all of these here. It keeps it. You can easily just re-click one of them and add it to a new post. You can also do stock photos from Unsplash. You can get animated stuff. This is Adobe Express stuff. You can do AI images if for some reason you want to. Dropbox or Google Drive, you can link your Dropbox and Google Drive stuff there and grab media from those accounts. Templates, I really like templates. I have to name them better so it's easier to get. But basically, these are like predefined little chunks of text that you can easily add into new posts that you're making. And down in configuration, we've got social accounts. There's very little configuration they need to do for any of these except for X or Twitter. You have to set up an API key and stuff, I believe. I have not done that. But setting up your accounts for all the other ones is very straightforward. You select it from the list. They got Facebook, Instagram, Threads, Mastodon, YouTube, Google My Business, Pinterest, LinkedIn Profile, LinkedIn Page, TikTok, Tumblr, Blue Sky, Reddit, Telegram. Basically, there's going to be two ways that you'll connect your accounts depending on what type of service it is. Some accounts, you click it, you put in your credentials, you're good to go. Some accounts, you select it, and then it will look at your browser and see what you're logged into and ask you to authorize. So to select multiple YouTubes, for example, or TikTok, I think it's the same, you have to basically like log into it in your browser. Connect it through Content360, log out of that in your browser, log into the second account, go back to Content360, click Add Account, TikTok, and then it'll ask you to authorize. Then you have both of those accounts set up to go. It's not entirely straightforward which ones do that, so there's no like indicator or anything. So you just have to realize if you're presented with an authorization screen, click out of it, log out of that account, and log into the new one, and click through the Add Account stuff again. Posting schedule, I don't use, but I believe you can select predefined times that you want posts to go in, and there's an add to queue button, and you can just click that and have the system kind of figure out when to schedule it, I believe. But again, I have not done this, although it probably is something I'll look into pretty soon. Webhooks, if you want to hook up a service that uses webhooks, WordPress, I believe, can do webhook stuff. Ghost will do webhooks. So you can connect other services to Content 360 that use that. Let's go ahead and let's click on the plus and create a post. Let's say I'm going to post a video to one of my YouTubes. I'm going to put a title in there, and I will select media, and I will drag and drop right there. And just like that, magically it is uploaded. We've got a little, it gives you previews over here. If you've got multiple ones selected, it can kind of give you an idea of how it'll look once posted. Now, if you're going to YouTube or any place that, any platform that lets you do cover images or thumbnails, once it's uploaded, you click it again. You're going to get a little preview window. You can remove it if you want to swap it with something else. Or if you go edit thumbnail, then you can pick a frame from it, or you can upload your own thumbnail. I'll go upload custom thumbnail. There you go. Apply. It's going to change it down here. Then you can go through and type in whatever you want. Now down here, you can add emojis. That's the media one we hit to upload the video. Hashtag manager, if you want to save group hashtags that you use frequently, you can do that here. I don't really use it. I just kind of put them into the templates. If you go template manager, this is where it has all those things. So right here, I've got gaming. I'll click use. It's going to pre-populate that there. I can go through and change this based on the information of what I'm posting. So I've gone through and I've copied and pasted from the page for this game into the stuff here. I do like single curly braces with the stuff that I need to manually put in, just what I do. And that's it. And we can go pick time if we want. And we can say, it'll be 5 o'clock in about 30 minutes. We can just do that there. We'll just schedule it there. All right, now it's been scheduled. You can see it's popped up in our posts page right here as scheduled Friday, 5 p.m. It's that simple. Now there's another option. You can see this has popped up, repeat. If we click that, we can actually, for any of these posts, we can kind of put it back into the Content 360 queue in the future right away. So we can say, like, it doesn't make much sense for YouTube, or at least not long form YouTube, but maybe Shorts it does, but TikTok or Instagram, you know, people pretty often repost old stuff. So you can say, like, hey, you know what? Yeah, every 2 months, let's put this up again, right? If you've got like an explainer video, like some like intro type video that explains what your account is or what you do or what you talk about or whatever, maybe that'll make sense to repost it frequently for new people to see. It's as simple as that. Now, let me do another one, and I won't actually post it, but I'll just give you like an idea of some of the cool stuff that you can do in this post panel. If I go to this one right here, this is going to be something that I've got a TikTok, an Instagram, a Facebook page, and YouTube for. And so you can kind of post to all of those very easily. It's, you know, same exact process. Let me pick one of these. I'll go insert, blah, 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 right? Who can watch your TikTok video? Everyone, comments, blah, blah. I wish this was default, but what are you going to do? New video, wow. So you can see you've got different options for different services, right? Post real story. You can, you know, go like that, do it however. What you can also do is you can see it says original right here, right? And then it lists all the stuff that it's going to. There's another little plus here. Let's go create version. And let's select one of the accounts that we're posting to. Now I'm going to say Facebook. And then it kind of breaks it out into its own tab. So original, it's going to be all of those except for the Facebook one. And over here, it's going to be Facebook. And you can see it copies over the text we had and the media we had. So what this does basically is that in one go, you can create, customized versions for each platform, whether that's, you want to post videos to all these platforms, but you also want to post like, you know, an image to Blue Sky or Twitter instead of like the video itself. Or what I'll do sometimes is I'll schedule a YouTube video, and then I'll take that link, and then I can send the YouTube link out to the places where that makes most sense. So like a Facebook post, for example, instead of a reel, where the post has the YouTube link in there, so it's kind of an embedded video in the feed, things like that. And you can do this however many times you need to. Just bam, pop it out. This also makes sense if you do, you know, like different platforms or different media sizes. So Blue Sky doesn't let you upload like any media. Like the space limit for media that you upload to Blue Sky is very low. So you might want to have individual images that you post there that are maybe lower quality or something that fit into those parameters versus what you'd put on Instagram or TikTok where there's, or Twitter, where there's, you know, they're much more relaxed on what media you can upload. So things like that. You know, that's kind of a quick rundown of this. I've been using it a lot. There are some quirks. One thing I forgot to mention, if you're uploading a YouTube video, you can change the thumbnail. You can't give it a default playlist to go into, and you can't upload your own subtitle file. If that's something that matters to you, that might be a tiny caveat, but I think really pretty minimal issues, and those are potentially things that can be fixed. There's been a number of improvements that I've seen just using it regularly in the last month, and I'm sure that's just going to continue to improve. So content360.io, my personal like link is down there. No one's bought it through it. I don't know if it works. I assume it does. Who knows? Use that if you want, or click the link and then get rid of the affiliate part at the end and use it without giving me anything. Either one's cool. I really do like this. I've been using it for a month now, like I said. And assuming it sticks around, this is going to be indispensable for me going forward, especially if you get it at a one-time fee. It's kind of a no-brainer. Even if you're not going to use it right now, you know, if you can't afford it, and you think in the future it might be something that you'll be able to use in, you know, months or whenever down the line, maybe it's something to think of. But and there's stuff coming in that they've talked about that has not actually been implemented yet. So it's only going to get better. You know, there you go. Check it out or don't. Follow your heart.